Good morning, everyone. So welcome today to today's sing-along as we celebrate singing and traveling to countries around the world. First, some trivia. Did you know that the U.S. and Canada share the largest border in the world? Over 5,500 miles stretch between our two countries. Okay. Our sing-along theme of World Songs recognizes two world celebrations that occur in October. The third Saturday of October is celebrated as World Singing Day. People from all over the world gather in groups of all sizes to sing all kinds of songs, plus one song that everyone sings in this global event. It began in 2012 by a nonprofit with the slogan, "Sing Together, Unite the World." Their website provides inspiration and resources on how to participate. The 24th of October has been celebrated as United Nations Day since 1948. United Nations Day marks the anniversary of the UN Charter and the founding of the international organization in 1945, after World War II ended and nations were in ruins and the world wanted peace. There are currently 193 member states. Our first song recognizes World Singing Day. Sing was written by Joseph Raposo and recorded by the vocal and instrumental duo of siblings Richard and Karen Carpenter on their album in 1973 titled Now and Then. The Carpenters produced a distinctive soft musical style, combining Karen's contralto vocals and drum playing with Richard's harmonizing, arranging, composition skills, and keyboard playing. During their 14-year career from 1968 to 1983, the Carpenters recorded 10 albums, along with numerous singles and several television specials. My song arrangement uses the humdinga strum in the key of F with 6 chords. I also refer to this as the la-la. Yeah, la-la-la-la song. So Rich and I will start this, and then we will call you in the second time around. So it goes, and then we have our ending. 1, 2, 3, 4. La-la-la-la-la. Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah. Go ahead, I forgot. Go ahead. Thank you. start our journey around the world by singing one of the most optimistic and uplifting songs ever conceived. What a Wonderful World was written by Bob Feel and George Weiss in 1967 and recorded by Louis Armstrong for ABC Records. Probably the most famous trumpet player in history, Louis Armstrong did not play his signature instrument on this song. During live performances, he would sing instead. The song was created to cut through the racial tensions of the 1960s, but due to the lack of promotion, it failed as a single on its first issue in the United States, although it topped the charts in many other countries. The song came to renewed attention after Armstrong's recording of it was featured on the soundtrack of the 1987 film, Good Morning, Vietnam. The song has since been recorded by many other performers and is a beloved standard. Louis Armstrong's version was inducted into the Grammy Hall of Fame in 1999. My song arrangement uses the pick and four strum in the key of B flat with 8 chords. Starts and goes and goes and goes. Bridge and last time and end. By Edith Moller for the German children's choir she conducted. In 1953, a BBC radio broadcast of the choir's performance at an international music festival in North Wales turned the song into an instant hit. Edith's brother, Frederick Wilhelm Moeller, had composed the tune after World War II. Dutch-born writer Antonia Roach wrote the English lyrics and used the French version of Velderie, Veldera, pronounced with the soft V sound. The words have no meaning. They are just nonsense syllables that are just good fun to sing. The song's German lyrics have been translated into several languages, and it has become a choir classic. My song arrangement uses the tom-tom strum in the key of G with three chords. So it starts, goes, and goes, and goes, and last time, and end. Two, three, four. Uses the bossa nova strum in the key of C with nine chords. chords. So we start, continues, we go to English, and last time and end. 2, 3, 4. The top image shows me pretending to be Julie Andrews, twirling around when we visited Austria in 1999. Edelweiss is the official flower of Switzerland that grows high in the Alps and is also the national symbol of Austria. In the Broadway musical, Captain Von Trapp uses the song to describe his love for his native Austria that is slowly dying due to the Nazis and the Third. In the movie, many viewers assumed Edelweiss was a traditional song of Austria rather than the creation of two American songwriters. This is the last lyric that Oscar Hammerstein published as he died in 1960, shortly after The Sound of Music opened on Broadway. My song arrangement uses two waltz strums in the key of F, with 6 chords. So we start, goes, and then we change strum for those who can, and then last time and end.
You.
Hebrew folk song translating to Let Us Rejoice, and is traditionally sung at Jewish celebrations, including weddings and bar mitzvahs. Although the Hebrew Bible may have been a source for the text of the song, the expression and accompanying circle dance is entirely secular. The melody is based on a Hasidic nijim, a wordless mystical song or prayer that is central part of Hasidic Judaism and was composed in 1915. There are competing claims of who wrote the lyrics. A condensed translation follows. Let's rejoice and be happy. Let's sing and be happy. Awake, brothers, with a happy heart. I think this is a happy song. So my song arrangement uses the humdinga strum in the key of D minor with a three chords. We will go slow and then fast. So it starts out slow, and then it goes fast. And if you can imagine them dancing around. So, three, four. Famous steps? Oh, wow. The song Arrivederci Roma was written by P. Garnet, S. Giovanni, and R. Ruskell in 1955. Arrivederci in English literally means until we see each other again, and is a common Italian equivalent of goodbye. The original lyrics express the nostalgia of a Roman man for the dinners and short-lived love affairs he had with foreign tourists who came to Rome. It recalls the popular legend associated with the Trevi Fountain, the largest Baroque fountain in Rome and one of the most famous in the world, and the site of the film, Three Coins in the Fountain. My song arrangement uses the bossa nova strum in the key of D with seven chords. So we start, second verse, and then the first verse is repeated, and then last time and a fade out ending. Two, three, four. With highly rhythmic and harmonic vocals, mostly often sung in French Creole. As English replaced French Creole as the dominant language, Calypso migrated into English. Lord Burgess, aka Irving Burgee of Brooklyn, New York, wrote the lyrics. His mother was from the Caribbean island of Barbados, and his father was from Virginia. It is believed that Burgess compiled and modified the song from many folk pieces to make a new song. Jamaica Farewell first appeared on Harry Belafonte's successful album Calypso in 1956 and reached number 14 on the Billboard's pop chart. The Kingston Trio, who led the folk revival of the late 1950s, took their name from this song. Did you know that? I didn't know that.
Oh, really?
The Kingston Trio took their name from this song and recorded Jamaica Farewell many years later. In the lyrics, the term aki rice refers to the fruit of a tropical tree indigenous to the Ivory Coast and Gold Coast of West Africa that was taken to Jamaica in 1793. It has some poisonous properties, yet if properly prepared, the fruit is often used as a food additive. My song arrangement uses the Latin strum in the key of G with three chords. So it starts. Chorus, verse, chorus, verse, chorus. Last time and a cha-cha ending again. Oops. Okay. 2, 3, 4. Also re-recorded it as a solo. recording the following year. A line in the song's lyrics inspired the title of the 1964 movie Paris, When It Sizzles, that was based on the 1952 French film Holiday for Henrietta. My song arrangement uses the humming a strum in the keys of G minor and G with 9 chords. This is a slow love song, so we start out slow. Goes and goes, and that's it. Very short. With lyrics in English. That's why we're singing this. It's in English. Yeah. In 1906, the Tin Pan Alley songwriters began their partnership in 1901 and collaborated successfully for more than a decade. Chinatown, My Chinatown was their biggest hit, but it did not catch on when they wrote it, and the musical review it was added to in 1910, Up and Down Broadway, was not especially successful. By the time the song became a national hit in 1915, the two were no longer collaborating. Many jazz artists recorded the song, including Louis Armstrong. My song arrangement uses the bossa nova strum in the key of F with 8 chords. So it starts and it goes. Song repeats itself, last time, and ending. Now to Ireland. Here is a medley of two St. Patrick's Day standards. The song My Wild Irish Rose is probably the most famous song written by Irish-American Chauncey Alcott. The inspiration came from a visit to his mother's homeland in 1898, when a young boy gave his mother a flower. When his mother asked the name of the flower, the boy replied, "A wild Irish rose." The song, When Irish Eyes Are Smiling, was co-written by Irish Americans Chauncey Alcott and George Graff Jr., with music by Ernest Ball in 1912. The song was based on a play set in Ireland in 1799 and has been performed by artists as varied as Bing Crosby and Frank Zappa. My song arrangement uses two waltz strums in the key of C and F with seven chords. Starts, goes, and then we go to my Irish Eyes Are Smiling, and then we end. The song Sukiyaki, also known as Ue Obue Te Aruko, meaning I look up as I walk, was written by Hachidai Nakamura and Rokusuke Ie in 1961. The song is about sadness and loss. In 1961, Kyu Sakamoto, as pictured here, was a star actor and singer in Japan, and his song Ue Obue Te Aruko was a number one hit. Sometime in 1962, a British music executive named Louis Benjamin heard the song when he was traveling in Japan, and he had his group record an instrumental version that made it to number 10 on the UK charts. Benjamin renamed the song Sukiyaki after a Japanese food he enjoyed, a one-pot dish made with sliced beef, tofu, noodles, and vegetables. The song made it to America when a disc jockey in Washington State heard the British version and started playing the original by Sakamoto. He used the title Sukiyaki for this song, which was easier for Americans to pronounce, and requests poured in. In 1963, Sukiyaki became the only song by a Japanese artist and the only song with lyrics entirely in Japanese to hit number one on the Billboard Hot 100 in the U.S. My song arrangement uses the Hamdila strum in the key of C with 8 chords. So it starts and it goes. There's a bridge. Verse. Lyrics and end. One time, two, three, four. The one by Frank Sinatra. My song arrangement uses the bossa nova strum in the key of F major 7 with 11 chords. All you ukulele players out there groaning, do not play. This is a sing-along, remember? Emphasis on singing. Okay, you're off the hook, so to speak. Yeah? I mean, this is good fun. Okay, so here we go. So we start. And it goes, and it goes. Last time, and two, three, four. Scale model with the songwriters, saying, quote, I need one song that can be easily translated into many languages and played as a round, end quote. The Sherman brothers wrote It's a Small World in the wake of the 1962 Cuban Missile Crisis, which influenced the song's message of spreading peace and brotherhood. The ride was created for the 1964 New York World's Fair and moved to Disney's California theme park after the fair closed. Let's move ahead. Okay, so my arrangement uses the pick and four and tom-tom strums in the key of C with three chords. So we pick the verse, change up for the chorus. Pick the verse, change up to the chorus, pick the verse, and last time, and end.
It's a small world after all.
today's program, we want to mention a heartfelt song that was written in 1965 by Hal, David, and Bert Bacharach. My husband Rich and I recorded our version of the song, What the World Needs Now. Added the audio track over photos we took while visiting peace memorials in Japan and connecting with people during our travels around the world, and made this video. You can watch it on my YouTube channel. So thank you all for coming today to our World Song Sing-Along. I hope you had fun singing songs about countries around the world, and I hope to see you again.
Mahalo! Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for ukulele lessons, music, and stories related to the songs. Are you having fun yet? See below to watch videos on my playlists. Have fun as you watch, listen, play the ukulele Mele way. Aloha from Maui. I am Mele Fong.